In this video, I am going to show you how you can shut down your PC remotely from anywhere just by using your smartphone. To get started, open your favorite browser and go to this web address. Link will also be in the description. Once you are on the web page, click on Download. On the download page, click on Download Full Version button, and this should start downloading the application to your computer. After the download is complete, click on the downloaded file, and click on Run. Click on Yes, and this should start the installation wizard. First of all, select your preferred language, and click on OK. Make sure to read the license agreements, and click on I agree. To install the application, click on Next. Now, click on Install. After the installation is complete, click on Finish. This should automatically start the application. To check whether the application has started, go to your taskbar and click on the small arrow pointing up. This should bring up the system tray. Over here, you should see a shutdown icon. But if you can't see the shutdown icon, then click on the Start menu and search for Airytec Switch Off. From the search results, click on Airytec Switch Off, and this should start the application. Now, go back to the system tray, and you should see the shutdown icon. Once you see the shutdown icon on your system tray, right-click on it, and click on Options. On the Options window, click on Remote. Click on the Enable Web Interface checkbox. This will help you to control your PC from a browser. Next, enter the port number you would like the application to listen on. Or, you can leave it at the default port, which is 8000. If you will like to be authenticated before accessing the web interface, then you will need to leave the Enable Authenticator checkbox enabled. But since I don't want to be authenticated, I will uncheck the Enable Authentication checkbox. After you are done, click on Apply. Now, click on View Web Interface. This will open your default browser and take you to a web page where you can control your PC. Over here, we can shut down, restart, sleep, and hibernate our PC through this web interface. We can also run custom scripts on our computer, right from here. To be able to access this interface and control our PC from our smartphone, open a new tab and go to ngrok.com. To be able to use Ngrok, you will need to create an account. To do this, click on Sign Up. Since I already have an account, I will click on Login. Let me quickly log into my account. After you sign up and log in, this will bring you to the Ngrok dashboard. Over here, you will need to download the Ngrok application. Click on the Download for Windows button to start downloading the Ngrok application. Wait for the download to complete. After the download is complete, minimize your browser, make sure you don't close it. Now, on the Airytec Options page, click on OK. Open File Explorer and go to your Downloads folder. In your Downloads folder, you will see a zipped file named Ngrok. Right-click on the zip file, and click on Extract to Ngrok. After the extraction is complete, double-click on the extracted folder to open it. Inside the extracted folder, you will see an Ngrok executable. In order to use this, click on the address bar inside File Explorer, and type CMD. After typing CMD, press Enter. This will open command prompt inside the current folder. Go back to your browser and make sure you are on the Ngrok dashboard. On the dashboard, scroll down and copy the second command. After copying the command, go back to your command prompt window and paste the command you have just copied. Inside the command prompt window, press Ctrl V to paste the command. Go back to the beginning of the command and remove the dot forward slash. Now, press Enter. After pressing Enter, you should see Auth Token Saved to Configuration File message. Next, type the following commands. Ngrok, space, HTTP, space. Now, type the port number you specified for your Airytec switch off. To get the port number, go to the system tray and right-click on the Airytec switch off icon. Click on Options and click on Remote. Now, you should see the port number in the port number section. Go back to your command prompt and type this port number. After typing the command with the port number, press Enter, and this will generate a URL that you can use to access the Airytec switch off webpage. In your command prompt, you should see these two URLs. You can use any of them to access the Airytec interface. With this, we can now be able to shut down our computer from our smartphone. To demonstrate this, let me quickly navigate to my smartphone. On your smartphone, open your favorite web browser. In the address bar, type any of the URL that is displayed in your command prompt. After typing the URL, press Enter. This will load and send you to the Airytec switch off interface of your computer. Let me zoom in for you. From here, you can shut down, restart, hibernate, or sleep your computer from anywhere at all, just by using your smartphone. If I tap on shutdown, my PC will automatically shut down, and I don't want to do that at the moment. To make this web interface super easy to access from anywhere, you can shorten the URL using a URL shortener. To shorten the URL, open your browser. In the address bar, type bit.ly and press Enter. If you don't have a Bitly account, you can create one by clicking on the Sign Up Free button. But since I already have an account, I will click on Login. Let me quickly log in. After registering and logging in, this will bring you to the dashboard. On the dashboard, click on Create. Now, go back to your command prompt and copy the Ngrok generated URL. Press Ctrl C to copy. Go back to your Bitly dashboard and paste the link you have just copied. After pasting the link, click on Create. You can also customize the shortened URL to your preference. After you are done customizing the URL, click on Save. This will shorten the long Ngrok URL to something much simpler. Let me minimize the browser and go back to my command prompt. Go back to your smartphone. Let me open a new tab and use the shortened URL to see if we can still access the Airytec interface. You can see it still works, and I can remember and use this customized URL from anywhere. I can access the Airytec interface from any other computer or smartphone. Another useful part of the Airytec Switch Off application is that you can create your own custom scripts, which you can run remotely from your smartphone. An example is the Open Calculator script showing here on the web interface. You can create your own custom scripts to perform any action on your computer. Now, let's create a script that deletes everything from our recycle bin and add it to the Airytec Switch Off interface. Before we create the script, go to the system tray and click on the Airytec Switch Off icon. Make sure to left-click, not right-click. On the Select Action section, click on the drop-down and select Predefined Scripts. Now, click on Edit Predefined Scripts. This will open the folder where you can add your custom scripts. Let's minimize the folder so we can create our custom scripts. To create our custom script, right-click on the desktop and click on New, then click on Text Document. Double-click on the new text document to open it. Now, type the following commands into the notepad. After you are done typing the commands, click on File and click on Save As. For the location to save the file, select Desktop. Type the name you will like to give to your script. After typing the name of the file, add .cmd at the end of the file name. After adding .cmd to the end of the file name, click on Save. Close the notepad. On your desktop, you should see the script we have just created. To test the script, let me delete this text document. Now, if I check my recycle bin, you can see that I have one document here. To test the script, make sure to close the recycle bin window. After closing the recycle bin, double-click on the script we have just created. Let me open the recycle bin again. If everything works fine, all the items in your recycle bin should be deleted automatically. And you can see, my recycle bin is now empty. Which means, the script works. If your script works fine, then we need to add it to the Airytec Switch Off interface. But if your script doesn't work as expected, then go back and watch the part where we created the script. To add the script to the Airytec Switch Off interface, right-click on the script and click on Copy. Now, go back to the scripts folder we have previously opened. Right-click in the scripts folder and click on Paste. If you see this pop-up asking for administrator permissions, click on Continue. This will copy the script to the Airytec Switch Off scripts folder. After adding the script, go back to your smartphone or any other computer and re-enter the Ngrok URL in your browser again. Let me refresh the page on my smartphone. Now, you can see the empty bin script here on the web interface. To check if it works, let me delete the script on my desktop so it can be moved to the recycle bin. You can see the file is here in my recycle bin. Let me now tap on the empty bin from my smartphone. After tapping on the script, it says predefined script will be executed in a moment. Let me check my recycle bin again to see if it works. You can see, my recycle bin has been cleared automatically, just by using my smartphone. With this, I can always clear my recycle bin remotely from anywhere. Airytec Switch Off also allows you to schedule tasks that run at a particular time. To schedule a task that runs at a particular time, go to the system tray and click on Airytec Switch Off. Over here, you can schedule a task that runs at a particular time. To schedule a task, click on the drop-down and select any schedule of your choice. Now, change the period you will like your task to run. From the Select Action drop-down, select the task you will like to run. Go to the bottom part as well and select your preferred options. After you are done scheduling your tasks, click on Enable Task, and your scheduled task should run at the specific date and time you have specified. To check if your task is enabled, hover over the Airytec icon and you should see some information about your task. To disable the task, click on the Shutdown icon and click on Disable Task. You can also check out other options when you right-click on the Airytec Switch Off icon in your system tray. So, in just a few steps, you should now be able to shut down, restart, sleep, and hibernate your PC remotely from anywhere, just by using your smartphone. Thanks for watching. Make sure to leave us a like, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and click on the bell icon so you can get notified as soon as we upload a new video. Also, don't forget to share this video. Thank you.